So setting out construction work.
Okay. In for SCTs, construction survey and modern techniques.
So here we are seeing today this setting out work means. So whenever the engineer give you plan, okay, say this is 30x40 site, okay, he will give one plan. So this is a 30x40 site, okay, he will give you a plan, but you have to put the same thing in this site, okay. Simultaneously I'll be showing you the figures and most important for each each engineer, civil engineer, okay. Not only putting the plan in the AutoCAD, but you also should know how to put it in the field, okay. Suppose say that this is your plan, okay, but this thing you have to execute or do markings in the field. So how we will make that one? So here you can see this image. So here you can see this is the AutoCAD plan, okay, that is, and the engineer will give, that is 30x40, okay, 30 feet by 40 feet. The same thing you have to put in the field, okay. So this is very important one for each engineer to do the line out in the site, okay. Line outing or so giving the center line for the columns are most important. So how we will do, what is the use and what are the steps that you have to follow before giving the line out? See, some whenever you see the field, there will be a lot of bushes, okay, or some trees will be there. lot of the bushes, trees will be present there. First thing we have to do site clearance. Okay, site clearance you have to do. Then after doing site clearance, the site should be well leveled. Okay, here you can see it is a in a good level manner. Okay, after that you have to fix the property line. Okay, you have to fix the property line. If you see the layout plan, okay, this is a road. Okay, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is plot number 1, plot number 2, plot number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that. Okay, and here plot number 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, and say that your plot number is 9. Okay, so before directly going providing this line out, you have first you have to confirm whether you have fixed your plot boundary or not. Okay, so you have to fix your plot boundary by taking the reference of the other building, if any other buildings are existing. If not, there will be a stone will be presented in the in your site, and they will write the plot number 9 somewhere here, plot number 10. It will be like this. So you have to see that one, and you have to check. Okay, once you have to check the measurement whether it is 40 feet or not. Okay, in width wise it is 30 feet or not. So after seeing all that, you have to think, check whether you are in the property line or not. Okay, after that, this is your built up area. Okay, this one is your site area. Site will be around 40 feet by 30 feet. Okay, so you here in your home you can see there will be a some gap. Okay, from main door to the compound there will be a gap of say 6 feet. At this side there will be a gap of 2 feet, here also 2 feet, back side 1 feet or over 2 feet, etc. So that what you have to do, then first you have to fix the size, plot size. Okay, after that you have to take the offset, how much it is there. Here it is 2 feet, so you have to take the offset of 2 feet here. From this side how much it is, it is offset of 2 feet. So from here also you have to take the offset of 2 feet. From front it is 6 feet, so you have to take the offset of 6 feet. You know how to take the offsetting. Okay, by using cross tab. And here it is 2 feet, so you can take the offset of 2 feet. Okay, this will be your built up area. Okay, again the same procedure will be there. If your building is of column, okay, then you have to give the column center lines, or if it is a load bearing means, you have to give the line out for the walls. Okay, external walls and internal walls. So here you can see, here what you see, this is the width for excavation. Okay, this much they will do excavation. This is just a glance. Okay, how the they will do the line out processing. Okay, so with respect to the syllabus, we will go in detailing. Okay, so as I said that before going to the setting out work or line out work, first we have to do site clearance. It's very important factor to be considered in the job layout plan. Okay, before the commencement of any project, because there will be a trees, plants, shrubs, big size stones, bushes, etc. So we have to remove those things. Okay, unwanted things. So approach road should be wide so as to allow the vehicle for loading and unloading of the construction material. Okay, not only just clearing the site, you should clear the site such that the material can be stored. Okay, either it may be a jelly, sand, rods, bricks. Okay, to store all these two materials, and you should have some convenient roads also. Okay, if the site is uneven, okay, then it should be made plain. Okay, for this countering is done in advance. Okay, actually for the high-rise building we will go for countering, but for normal building with the help of JCB we will make it a level one. Okay, study the final levels of the approaching ground before starting the line out. Okay, site cleaning and fair leveling of the plot should be completed. For example, this is your site, okay, and here there is a road. Okay, so check whether your site is above the ground level or below the ground level, first one thing. Okay, the second thing is that if you go for high rise building, you have to do excavation around 20 feet, okay, 30 feet like this. Okay, so what we will do, this is a road. Okay, so this road level, what we will take as a reference of RL 100, okay, for benchmark 100. Then with the help of the portal station or auto level, we will determine the levels, okay, for respective structures. Okay, either for foundation, okay, PCC, first we will provide PCC, then for columns, okay, again we will get plinth, beam, etc. You already studied about these, the structural elements. So the level should be determined. This helps in obtaining the correct measurement without any obstruction. So with the help of the taking the levels, we will come to an exact how much we have to excavate. Okay, if you have excavated already half inch, you will come to know how much we have excavated and still how much we have to excavate. Okay, in short, site should be cleaned properly by all ways. Otherwise, no other construction process are carried out further. Note that for cutting of higher trees, an application should be submitted to the municipal corporation. Okay, because nowadays cutting of trees is not a legal one, it is an illegal one. So you have to take the permissions from the municipality, or if any electrical poles have came to your site, or any towers, okay, any towers are there. So shifting of these poles, towers, or cutting of trees, we have to take the permission from the municipal corporation. Okay, and the actual cutting of the tree should be done as per the procedure of municipal authorities. Okay, which is how the very first thing is that the site clearance. Okay, preparing job layout for the setting of work. A plan in which the arrangement for the placing site office, okay, storeroom, labor quarter, medical aid center, godowns, and keeping the construction materials and other facilities properly prepared and chalk out is made as the job layout or the site layout. So this all comes in a high-rise building, okay, where you have to provide the labor homes, storerooms to store the materials. Okay, normally for the small buildings, okay, we will make a small shed. Okay, in that we will keep the cements and the steels, etc., will be kept outside. But in high-rise building, we have to make a proper layout. Okay, if this is your construction area, okay, the remaining area, it should be divided very well. Okay, say that this is the for laborers, okay, laborers colony, where the laborers can be commenced. See, so I will divide this as an office room, okay, where engineers sit here or do some their paperwork in the office room. So here I will give providing for the steels, okay, laying of the steels. And here near to the site, what I will do, I will provide the storeroom so that the material can easily be shifted to the site. Okay, this proper layout should be done. Okay, the arrangement of the purpose should be such that the work is done smoothly and in a orderly manner. Orderly manner. In this job layout plan, there should be a proper correlation and coordination among the different units. Just now I said that there should be a such that see the labor house or labor colony is nearer to the site, so that they will be quickly sent to the site. Say whether it is situated far away from the site, so there will be a lag of time. Okay. And say if there is an office outside the site, okay, there will be a miscommunication between the labor and the office. Okay, so everything if it is present within the site means, so there will be good interaction between the laborers, engineers, and also during the supplies of the materials. Okay. Actually, whatever you are seeing, this will be in the high-rise building. In such a way that site office, warehouse are placed close to the entrance of the site. Okay, so to have a better contact with the visitors. This is a full theoretical part. Okay. The area should be properly allotted in a such a way that time required in carrying the material is minimum. Just now I said that shipping of the material will be quicker as it is situated nearer to the site. Okay. Job layout depends upon the three factors, namely location, area, topography of the site. Okay. You may ask it for MCQs. If you want, you can take a screenshot. Job layout depends upon the three factors. Okay, that is layout location. Okay, where it is situated, area, topography. Okay, method of construction, nature, and the type of the work. Okay, and we have different types of works. Okay, you can take building work, road work, tunnel work, bridge work, etc. Method of construction, it may be so it may be a column building. Or load bearing building. It may be a residential building, it may be a high rise building. So we have different types of methods. So setting out a foundation plan for load bearing structure, okay, and frame structure. First I will show you what you mean by load bearing structure and what you mean by frame structure. This you already learned in the building material construction. So here you can see, this is the load bearing structure where the excavation will be done for a required depth, say around 4 feet to 5 feet. Okay, that is 1.2 meter to 1.5 meter. Sorry, 1.2 to 1.5 meter. And here there will be no any column structures. Okay, load bearing means the entire load will be taken by the foundation, that is either built by brick masonry or stone masonry. Okay, usually there it will be, the foundation will be in terms of stone masonry. Okay, say that the excavation will be done to up to 4 to 5 feet. Okay, this is your ground level. Okay, so I will do the excavation say around 4 feet, or unless I get the hard strata at the bottom, usually it will be 4 to 5 feet, and the width I will say I will excavate around to 4 feet or 5 feet. Okay, in load bearing structure, the bottom most it will be PCC. Okay, it will be PCC, it will be around say 100 mm. Okay, above which you will get the stepped footing. Okay, you will get stepped footing. Okay, this is your chapter 14. Of size stone masonry. Okay. Above that, here I will provide DPC, that is damp proof concrete. Okay. Above which the brick wall will be constructed. Okay. This is a BBM in cement mortar 1:6. Okay. See here. Giving the line out for the load bearing structure. Okay, is different as compared to the column buildings. So first I will show you what you mean by load bearing structure. Once you have already learned, just I will give a glance. Here, frame structure. Okay. So again, here the excavation will be the same. Okay, 5 feet by 5 feet. The first layer, that is substructure, the first layer will be the PCC of 100 mm thick. Okay, here I will give footing. Okay, and this will be my column. This is of concrete. I will call this as a footing depth. This is the footing depth. It may be varies. It varies depends upon the loads. Okay, either it may be 300 mm or residential 400 mm, 450 for residential building. Okay, if you go for high rise structures, means it will be close to 1.2 meter, 1.4 meter. Okay, this will be your column. Okay, this will be your column. It may be up around M20 grade concrete, M25 grade concrete, up to M40 grade concrete. Okay, size vary from the minimum size will be 230 by 230 or 230 by 300. Correct. So, in frame structure, if I draw the front elevation, so this is my first column, second column, third column, fourth column, and these horizontal things are the beams. Okay, in frame structure, we will be having column and beams. So we will call this one as a frame structure, beam, column, and slab. After constructing this beam, column, slab, okay, then what we will do later, we will construct the walls. Okay, after this one, we will construct the walls. Okay, this is the actually the difference between the load bearing structure and the column structure. Okay. So here you can see this is a I have taken the simple diagram. And here you can see the sizes. Here it is 23 feet width and the length is 51 feet. Here you can see the width is how much? 23 feet. Okay. And the length is 51 feet. Okay. This is just simple plan. Okay. To make you understand very quickly, so I have taken a simple plan. Here you can see I have provided the columns here. Okay. Here you can see I have provided the columns. It is a plain structure one. And here beside this shed, we have provided one small building. Okay. This is actually a goat shed. Okay. So just to look up these goats. So for a watchman, there is a single one-story house is there. Its width is a 9 feet 6 inches and 14 feet. Okay. So here also we have provided the four columns. So now the important thing is that here you can view the layout by two methods. Okay. Just you can give the, if you don't want to provide the columns, okay, you can give the line out for the buildings, for the walls. Okay, this wall. Okay, if you want to construct by using the columns, means you can give the center line layout for the columns. Okay. So actually the foundation details is not there in this. So what we will do, first we will go to the side, we will clear the everything, we will clear the side. After that we will fix the boundary. Okay, so we will fix this end. First we will fix this point, this point, this point and this point. Yeah, it's there. This is the same plan. Okay, so I have taken the column layouts. I have drawn a center line to the columns. Okay. And I will draw this one. So here you can see the distance between one column to another column, it is 13 feet 6 inches. Here you can see I have one column here and another column here. The distance between one column to another column is how much? 13 feet 6 inches. Okay. Another, from the second column to the third column, it is 8 feet 9 inches. And from here to here, 8 feet 9 inches. Correct. So after clearing the set part, first I will fix this point, here also I will fix the four points. Then what I do, I know the distance between one point to another column, okay, one column to another column. Just what I will do, with the help of the tape or with the help of the cross tab, you can use any of method. You can use new methods or you can use the old method, old traditional methods. Okay. So we know the distance between this. Here you can see this is column 1, column 2. So we know the distance, so we will leave the offset. Similarly, C3, we know the distance. From C1 to C4, here you can see this is C4, we know the distance. Okay. So again, we will leave the offset. Then from here to here, we know the total distance, that is 13 feet 6 inches and 8 feet 9 inches. So we will add those and we will give another offset. Similarly, like this. So we will provide the whole details. And here what we will do, we will provide the excavation details or footing details. Here you can see this is the frame structure. So first what we will do, here we have given the center line like this. This is the column. Okay. Then I want to do excavation. Okay. Excavation, how much I will give? If you see the figure, Here we will mention column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, up to column 10. And the column sizes are 9 inches by 9 inches is nothing but 230 by 230 mm. And here we have footings. Okay, footing details. Footing number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 10. The depth of the excavation is 5 feet. 5 feet is nothing but 1.5 meter. Okay. And footing size, it is 4 feet by 4 feet. That is 1.2 meter by 1.2 meter. Okay. So this is my grid line. Okay. Here you can see this is the grid line. And this is the column position. What I will do? My footing size is how much? 1.2 by 1.2. So what I will do? I will leave here 0.6. Here I will leave 0.6. Okay. From here it is 0.6. From here it is 0.6. 0.6, 0.6, 0.6, 0.6. So we have got the footing size. So the same procedure we will go on carrying this one. Okay. Directly going into the syllabus, so I am giving some ideas. Okay, by seeing your figures, we'll come to know what actually it is, which will be there. See, actually, before giving the line out, okay, this was actually the field. Okay. Actually, the farmer who constructed that shed in the field. Okay, actually, it was not inside the inside the city. Actually, it was in the open area. So here you can see the bushes which are present here. What we will do first, we will do the clearance. Here you can see all the bushes are there. So what we will do with the help of the JCB or any type of dozer, what we will do, site clearance. Okay, so after doing site clearance, one more thing you should remember, that the site should be almost level. Okay, it should be almost level. So then actually what I wanted to say that I wanted to give the pillars for this client. Okay, but at the last moment the client cancelled this one. Okay, he doesn't wanted to provide the columns, just he wanted to construct the simple walls. Okay, by providing for footing with the size of masonry. Okay, so he wanted to he said that just cancel the columns, and he said that we'll go for load bearing. Okay, he said we'll go for load bearing. So here you can see, just you can see the plan. Okay, these are the walls. So what I did is that I just transferred these figures, okay, these walls, okay, into the ground. Here you can see, first whatever I fixed one property lines. Okay, here you can see the rods. Okay, here you can see the rods. So what we will do, we will fix them. Okay, we will fix them and we will do them perfectly in a right angled triangle. Okay, it should be perfectly rectangle. After that, here you can see actually our wall width was 9 inches. So for the excavation, what I did is that I given 1 foot. Okay, so 1 foot excavation, and later on in the, if you go for JCB means, it will be nearly equal to 1.5 feet width. Okay, so here we first we will draw one line and then we will put offsets. Okay, here you can see the length. We have here also you can see the rods. So we have taken the offsets. So one thing is that we have to
fix these lines. Okay, the four pegs are most important, that are the four corners of your building. Okay, either you can take outside the building or center line or middle, whichever it is convenient for you. Okay, then you have to give the offset. If you are going for the load bearing means, you have to give the offset for the either for the width of the wall or width of the excavation. If it is the column, center line column method means, you have to give the excavation for the this one, sorry, footing size. Okay, okay, see you. This is our building plan, that is 2 BHK. okay, and the sizes are 8 meter by 10 meters. Okay, so this will be our respect elevation and this will be our cross section. Okay, if you see the cross section, it is a column building. Okay, it is a column building. Actually the plan will look like this. Central line, I have AutoCAD drawings. It's okay. This one. So before going for the site clearance, initially I have said that you have to finalize your plot one. Okay. If I show this one means the very first step you will come to understand. So this will be your layout plan. Okay, if you ask your parents, show me the layout plan of our area. Okay, either your area may be Mahatma Gandhi area or Shivaji area, whatever. Okay, if you ask the plan of your living area, means your area, so they will show like this. Okay, in that say that your plot number is 12. Okay, your plot number is 12 and this site is empty. Okay, this site is empty and here there is a building. Okay, and here also there is one building, here also there is a building. Okay, so this is your plot. Okay, before going for the construction, what I have to do, see, you have to take this layout plan. Okay, without taking this layout plan, you can't fix your plot area. So here there is one building, okay, already constructed. So from, and this is your building, okay, plot area that you want to construct. So from here to here, how much it is, the distance, it is 36 feet 11 inches, right? It is 36 feet 11 inches. So what you have to do, you have to take the tape and you have to leave 36 feet 11 inches, and you have to put one rod or peg. You have to put one peg. From here you have to leave 36, take the chain, leave 36 feet 11 inches, 36 feet 11 inches, and here provide one peg. Okay, so we got two corners, so still we left with the two corners. So what, here the site is empty. Okay, here the already one building is there, so you have to keep the tape here and you have to measure, that is it is 11 no that it is that 36 feet 11 inches. So take the tape and leave here 36 11. So you have got all the four corners. So if I draw like this, I will draw a little bit, I will draw incline. Okay, I will call this one as A, B, C, D. You have got incline.
Okay, actually, whenever you take the measurement from the fixed building, okay, you should not take from the empty side, you should take from the building one. Okay, so after taking that, after fixing the pegs, it will be like this. Okay, it will not be rectangle. Okay, perfectly rectangle. So the important thing that you have to do is that, so you have to use Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so I will call this one as 3 meter 4 meter 3 meter 4 meter. So to make it a perfectly rectangle, so what I will do, I will calculate the hypotenuse. Okay, so that is, we know the formula, 3 square plus 4 square equals to, we have got 5. So I have got 5 here. I will keep my tape here and I will measure 5. Okay, so we have to little bit, we at this point where we place the peg, we will not get actually 5, it will get somewhere here. So we have to move the rod little bit of inward or outward. Again, I will keep my tape here, I will measure 5 meters, say I will get somewhere here. After doing all those adjustments, we will get perfectly rectangle. Okay, so this is very important. Before giving the line out, you have to fix the your plot area. Okay, this is the most important thing. So I hope you have got some idea. Now I will go into the syllabus. Actually, it in 3 class or 4 class or in 10 class, you won't understand anything. Okay, unless and until you enter into the field. Okay, by holding tape, line drawing or thread, color, until you take them and you enter into the field, you won't understand anything. If you see n number of videos also, it is very less. Surveying is a subject such that until you do on your own in the field, and until that, you won't understand anything. But I'm trying my best to give you some ideas, maximum ideas, so that even if you go with the by seeing all these videos or by attending my lectures, if you go to the site, means I hope around 80% you will be strong enough to give the line out. Okay, I will try my level best. So setting out of the foundation, so foundation, those things I have already said. Quickly I will read it. Architectural prepare final layout. Okay, our line out diagram, either it may be a plan or it may be a central line diagram. Central line diagram means it will be like this. Okay, central line diagram, it will be like this. Okay, and the plan will be like this. Okay, with the help of this one you can give the line out, or with the help of this one you can give the line out. Okay, so in the final layout of the line out diagrams, the position of masonry walls in the load bearing structures and the position of the column in the frame structures is marked. Okay, I have already shown you. In short, a separate line out plan. Okay, here you can see if this is a separate line out plan or a baseline plan for the position of the walls and columns is prepared. Okay, so this one I already shown you just now, this layout diagram. Okay, we will call this one as first. I will, okay, this is a layout diagram. Here it is a road here, and here it is a main road. Okay, this is called, we will call it known as a layout diagram. Okay, the same thing he has shown you. So these all I have already said. So quickly I'll go it. Okay, this is the first point. Here it is a line out or a layout of the building. Okay, building A, building B, building C, building D. Okay, and here these are the boundary lines. The second point is that a fixed benchmark or a permanent object is first decided for taking the measurements for the
as per layout diagram approved by the architecture, measure the various distance from the permanent object, which is considered in a counter map as a benchmark. So just now I have shown that you take the reference of the one building, okay, and mark the another one, okay, or the which one you want to do line noting, okay. Now mark the straight line on the ground parallel to the compound wall, okay, because compound wall will be your plot area, sorry, site area, okay, 30-40 site area. So the compound will be constructed along the edges of your plot site. Okay. Fix up any corner of the building. Okay, means I said that we will provide one peg, okay, pegs or rods, and then a line parallel to the front of road called as baseline should be fixed. Note that the baseline should be marked from the center of the road, taking into consideration and the road winding in the further. Okay. Here you can see this is my road. Okay, this is the center line of the road. Okay, we will use some offset, okay, because further there will be a widening of the road, so this should be taken into account. From the baseline with the minimum setback from the road as per line out diagram, layout diagram, a building is fixed as seen in the figure. Okay, here we can see. Set up the prismatic compass or a theodolite on any one corner, and by taking the perpendicular measurements. Okay, you can take, there are n number of taking with the perpendiculars, so you can follow any one of the methods. Okay, with the help of the chain, with the help of the cross stop, with the help of the tape, okay, with the help of the theodolite compass, so we can take the perpendiculars or we can take the offsets. At this stage, check the required setbacks for locating all the building as shown in the plan. Okay, check the plan, check the area of the plan, open space between the different building. Okay, this is for the load bearing one. Similarly, for the center line method, we have for face structures, we have center line and face line method. Okay, just now I have said, so we will call these are the grid pillars. Okay, we will call these as the grid pillars. Just now I have shown you, here you can see 1, 2, 3. Okay, here A, B, C. Okay, these are the lines which are passing through the center of the column. Okay, if this is your column, it will be passing through the center. This also I have explained you. The central line, this also runs. Okay. So this one, what you see, this is your site boundary. Okay, so from here we will be having some offset. Okay, initially I said 1 feet offset, 2 feet offset, 3 feet offset will be there, or 1.5 feet will be there. So you will leave the offset. Okay. Okay. Checking of right angle of a line node. Okay. Just now I said that you are building. So when you take the offset in this one, okay, when you take the offset, your plot will be, when you place the rods, it will be like this inclined. Okay, it will not be perpendicular, it will not be perfectly rectangular. It will be little bit inclined. So we have to make this into the perfectly rectangular. So what we will do with the help of the rectify method, that is so we will make it a perfectly rectangle by using Pythagoras theorem, or we will call it as a 3-4-5 method. Okay, and we have different types of instruments also. I will show that one also. I If you observe in the site, okay, the mestri or the mason will be using this type of scale. Okay, quickly I will explain the principle and how to use this one. So see here. This is my A. Okay, I have placed one rod here. This is a straight line. Okay, this is the B. Okay. Actually, your line, it will go like this. Okay, it will be little bit in inclined form. Okay, like this. So with the help of this scale, I will draw that perpendicular scale. Okay, this will be the scale. Okay, I will call this one as edge A. I will call this one as edge B. Okay, it will be perpendicular one. So what I will do, I will keep my one edge A. Okay, here. So it will come like this. Okay, this is my scale. I will keep my scale with a long line AB. Okay, a long line AB. So what I will do? So here I have fixed one rod, okay, that is D. What I will remove it, and I will slowly bring towards this scale. Okay, when it is in the line, okay, when it is in the line, I will fix it. Okay, the rod will be fixed perpendicularly. Okay, if you remove the scale, it will be perpendicular. Okay, similarly, what I will do, I will keep my scale here. Okay, and I will bring the line here perpendicular. After joining, you will get a perfect rectangle. Okay, this is the procedure how we use the perpendicular scale and make the site or a now check off the right angle corner of the line out. Okay, it can be measured by taking the tape, okay, and making the arrangement of 3 4 5, okay, with the help of 3 4 5 method. Okay, or you can use the perpendicular scale also. And such that it gives the right angles at the corner of the line out. Means how to use this one is that very simple. So what I will do, here it is 0 tape. From here to here it is 3 meter. In tape it should show 3 meter. From here to here it is 4. 3 plus 4 will be 7 meter. Here it will, in tape it should show 7 meter. When you, and you should bend your tape, and when you hold here, it should show 12 meter. 0, 3 meter, 7 meter, 12 meter. Okay, this is what 3 4 5 method. What are the precautions for making the setting out on the ground? Okay, what are the precautionary measures that we should take during the line outing? Okay, all vertical wooden posts, or you can use rods, okay, should be firmly fixed into the ground. Okay, if you are fixing into the ground, it should be firmly fixed. Okay, because the thread will be tied to this one. Okay, if you pull, means it should not come, or it should not bend like this. The rod should not bend like this. Should be fixed into the ground with the concrete, or and the curing should be done to the concrete wall for a period of 7 days. Okay, nobody will do this one. Okay, horizontal wooden planks and railing should be straight and should be have a standard size. Okay, wooden plank also we want to use. If I show you that figures. We are all, we use the grids, okay. Just now I saw. Means like this, we will provide the wooden panels. Okay. So nowadays we are not practicing this one. Directly we use the threads. Okay. With the help of the threads, we provide the line routing. Okay. The joints of the wooden railing should not be overlapped. Okay. But should be joined by a small wooden plank here. If you see, where is the figure? Okay. Here. Here we can say it is joined by the another small piece. Okay. It is not overlapped, but it is means it has been this is one wooden plank and this is another wooden plank. It is joined by another small wooden plank. Okay, it should be done like this. Okay, it should not be overlapped like this. Then all vertical posts should be kept generally at the same levels. Horizontal wooden railing should have same levels. Okay. Throughout and level should be found either by the tube or dumpy levels. Okay, tube leveling will be there. You can see the masonry will be holding the small pipes. Okay, that one with the help of that one he can do, or he will be having one scale. Okay, which will be having spirit level, or with the help of the dumpy level. Okay, railing should be fixed by the nails of 50 mm diameter to have a good grip. The nail of 40 mm diameter should be used on railing for locating the center of the column, okay, the frame structures, and for locating the center of the masonry in the load bearing structure. So there are n number of precautions. Just go through them. Now setting out of the culvert. Setting of the culvert, it is not that much important, but setting out of the bridge. Okay, first I will show you what you mean by culvert. Later I will go for the bridges. So here you can see these are the concrete culverts. In olden days, there will be a stone culverts. Okay, this one what you see, this is called as a box culvert. That is seen pre-stressed to concrete box culvert. Okay, this is already which is constructed in the working area, and it will be transported to the site. Okay. If we are using the concrete basements, it will be a if we are using this concrete pipes, it will be a concrete vent pipe culvert. Okay, and the stone culvert will show you. Okay, these are the culverts which has been built in the olden days. Okay. So setting up the stone culvert, it is not that much important. Here quickly I will explain here. See, this is your culvert. Okay, this is your wall. Okay, this is your wall. Say that the car will be. The car will be moving in this direction. Okay. So I will call this one as a longitudinal section, longitudinal way, and this is a transverse section or transverse one. So, and one, remember one thing, the car is moving in this direction. Second, I will take a little bit bigger. Okay, here you can see the vehicle will be moving in the longitudinal way. Okay. So how to give this line dot means? What we will do? We will take the center, okay, along the longitudinal direction and also along the transverse direction. So this one, what you see, this is the center line, okay, or we call it as a went way, pathway. Okay. If I draw, if I change the figure, this is the pathway. Okay. So I will take the center line of this one. Okay, and this is the cross section. This is the center line of the cross section, transverse way. Okay. What I will do here? First, I will be knowing the distance between from here to, or I will be knowing the entire distance, that is the length of the culvert. So from the center line, what I will do, I will take the offset from here, okay. Next, I will be knowing the distance from here to here, okay. Then what I will do, I will give the offset from here also, I will give the one offset. Similarly, this is, this same procedure will be done at this point, okay. Similarly, I want to leave the offset. See, now I want, I know that this distance, what is the pathway distance? Say it is around 3 meter. Okay. If I take the center alignments, if this is the center alignments, it will be 1.5 meter and 1.5 meter. Okay. I will be knowing the wall width, say it is 0.9 meter. This is 0.9 meter. So what I will do here, this center line AB, from here I will leave one offset, okay. So I will get the this wall. From here I will leave offset of 0.9, I will get this wall, okay. From here this I will be knowing this distance, so I will leave another offset, so I will get this endpoint. Similarly it will be done here. From this O point I will leave one offset, I will get the inside wall. I will leave another offset, I will get outside wall. So this is how we do in the box culvert. Okay. This is how we do the online. This is the procedure of providing the setout work for the culvert. Okay. Similarly, we have the bridge work. Here also we have the same procedure. So we will see one by one. Bridge survey or location of the
location survey.
The transit stadia or tachometry is used for topographic survey of the bridge. So I'm not able to take the class, so better to take 1 hour gap, okay. After 1 hour